Leonard Bernstein is a composer, conductor, and pianist.
Hello, I'm Lenny.
Leonard Bernstein was an American conductor-composer who changed the face of classical music.
Making a story about that type of man was just incredibly exciting.
I've never had so much fun researching a project in my life. I didn't want to leave it. I wanted to be in that world.
I've never been involved in something for such a long time. Bradley was calling me like 3 years before we started shooting as Lenny.
Right.
So I was like, okay. That set such a high bar for what this needed to be.
I think Bradley showed us with A Star Is Born that he knew how to tell a really beautiful love story with a backdrop of music. And so I knew that he was the right person to direct and star in the film, and he just worked 24/7 to bring the story to the screen.
My brother and sister and I were overwhelmed, really, that Bradley decided to make this film really about the relationship between our parents.
Oh, life is not that serious. Honest, it isn't. What age are we living in? One can be as free as one likes without guilt or confession. Please, what's the harm? I know exactly who you are.
Bradley found something really stunning and inspiring in this modern love that they had had.
We knew that this was the way to tell the story. This was the way into Leonard Bernstein's life.
And this is a story that I thought, as an audience member, I could relate to, because you always want to make it something that the audience can connect to, relate to, even though it's utterly cinematic.
So how long do we have to do this for?
Well, we need to build up a very strong connection.
Well, we knew that we wanted to make a movie that would encompass their whole relationship, which occurs over many decades.
Because we span 5 decades, you have to find a way to take you through a chapter of their life, end it, and transition to the next chapter. It's using formats of film, black and white, different aspect ratios, and different periods of makeup.
Leonard Bernstein, he's so iconic looking, and it was so important to achieve that look on Bradley's face. The important part is not to do too much and make it comfortable for actor.
Every day before crew call, Kazu and I would get together in a little trailer 3 to 5.5 hours before every day and put Lenny on. It was incredible.
The makeup was just, I just couldn't get my head around it. It was so remarkable.
Every single day of this shoot was executed fearlessly, whether it was makeup, a set, costume, and that was like a huge blessing to have absolute titans at each head of a department. And Mark Bridges, who I had met years ago on Silver Linings Playbook, I knew that he was perfect, and he really was.
Part of my storytelling is pinpointing when it is, and therefore using different colors for the different periods. We start the film fashion-wise with women, purse, jewelry, stockings, high heels, very proper. And by the time we're finished, there's such a change in mores and the way people wear clothes.
Everything helps so much, and the wardrobe was just stunning.
It's a great tool, that passage of fashion, to tell that passage of time.
Hello, how are you?
Charlie.
I have all my hands.
And then Kevin Thompson brought his expertise.
For production design, you always look at a lot of visual reference. What is the reality? Where did they live? What did it look like?
Pleasure to meet you. How are you? Are you having a good time?
Bradley wanted to go to the real places. And if we couldn't go to the real places, we were going to create them within an inch of their lives.
We shot at their home. Mm. We went to Tanglewood. We conducted Mahler's Second Symphony in Ely Cathedral. I just knew it would benefit us, and it did at every turn.
We talked a lot about accuracy, texture, and keeping a certain amount of organic nature to the design, where we could shift and shape how each scene bleeds into the next.
We were just sort of bringing all these elements together to help transition from these periods of time, and it allows you to see and be in that time period.
Oh my God! It's such a huge responsibility to play real people.
When you're casting a role that is based on a real person, you do want it to look like the person, but more than anything, you want the actor to capture their spirit.
Because Carey was there, she was so inhabiting Felicia, she just took it to another level.
You're letting your sadness
get the best.
Let me
this
at least finish. Let me finish
me.
What
no.
I'm going to
no.
say.
It was just a gargantuan endeavor for us as actors.
It's about you, so you should love it.
I just think the whole cast is extraordinary. Everybody really brought their A game and just jumped right into the story.
It always just felt like the characters were walking in. It just always felt like that. And that's just gold for a filmmaker.
I was listening. You were wonderful.
You as well. Oh. Broadway star.
Oh, no. To see this whole film come together and to watch Bradley portraying our dad at all these different ages in his life, it was so remarkable to us.
Like our father, he comes from a place of real love and dedication to his art, his craft, and everyone he works with. And that definitely comes through in the film.
Part of the first conversation with Bradley was, if we're gonna do this, you've gotta go all in.
And I wanted it to be real, I wanted it to be infectious. It was just the most joyous experience I've ever had in my life.
It was kind of acting heaven.
I've worked on many sets, and I have never experienced something as special as this film. It wasn't easy, but it was just magic.